Critical battery, please charge. So here we are once again in this moment, the only moment that there is this moment. Deepest teaching of yoga is the awareness of this precious present moment. The secret of mindfulness is being aware of the present moment. So in this movement practice, I'll invite you to keep coming back to your experience, taking the opportunity to move your joints, all of the joints of your body in their various ranges of motion to your capabilities today, which is different than yesterday, certainly different than a year ago, and will be different than tomorrow. And I'll offer variations, as always, and instructions on how to best align your spine and your joints for the most freedom of movement. And freedom, such a wonderful thing. It may seem like right now, these days, our freedoms are limited. But just take a moment to have gratitude for all of the new possibilities that have been coming our way. Whatever that is in your life, have gratitude for new possibilities. And so we'll take the next couple of minutes to come to a comfortable seated position. And you can sit on your chair. You can sit on your couch. You can sit on the floor. And you can even be, if you're not able to actually sit with us right now and take the opportunity to join your own spirit and your own mind and your own body in a series of mindful movements and just have it on in the background, that's fine. Just from the part of your brain that doesn't need to figure anything out, maybe just kind of listen along, do the best that you can to follow along. And so we'll use the chair again today as a prop, as for support and for teaching. But you can also, if you're more comfortable, you can be, again, like seated on the floor. If you need to be, you could be seated at the couch. And at some points, I'm going to ask you to come to sit the edge of your chair or sit at the edge of the couch so you can have your feet on the floor. And so if you're sitting in a chair, have your knees coming straight out of your hips and your toes facing forward, the eye of your knee facing your toes. And the center of the crown of the head, right over the center of the heart, right over the bowl of the pelvis. So find the center, exact exquisite center of your sits bones by rocking back and forth. And you roll back on the sits bones. And you roll forward on the sits bones, back and forth a few times, and then come to stillness right at the center of your sits bones. And we'll just begin our practice this afternoon by stabilizing your body, stabilizing your breath, giving the opportunity for the nervous system to calm down a little bit, and for you to land more and more here into this moment, allowing the time it takes for your mind to kind of slow down a little bit and using the tool of the breath to do so. So let's take a couple of breaths together, shall we? If it feels like the right time and it feels comfortable, I invite you to close your eyes. Just invite your eyelids to close down towards your cheeks, towards the pillow of the cheeks. Again, drop back into your back body. Roll your shoulders back. Notice how that engages your abdominal muscles a bit. And take a few deep breaths. You can exhale out with a sounding or a from your mouth if you like for the first couple of breaths. Eventually, coming to a place with, if possible, that you can breathe in and out through your nose. Breathing in, lengthening, lifting, expanding. Breathing out, landing into the support of your chair, of the earth, of your cushion. Relax your face and your jaw, your cheeks. With each exhalation, it invites your parasympathetic nervous system to kick in more than your sympathetic nervous system. So your more relaxing aspect of your nervous system comes into play here with each exhalation, with each deep exhalation. And then just come to an awareness of your natural breath moving freely and effortlessly through your body. Your belly expands as you breathe in, and your belly draws back as you breathe out. Feel the ribs expand. Feel the breath moving into the kidneys and adrenals on each inhalation. And with each exhalation, landing more and more, dropping into your sits bones, dropping into your back body. Everything you've done to get to this point, it's all good. With gratitude. And perhaps even with a sense of joyous exploration as an attitude for this practice. Hatha Yoga Uttasanan. Herein lies the teachings of yoga. May this experience be joyful, enlightening, even within its potential challenges, have a sense of, like I said, joyous exploration. So we'll begin, as always, with a couple of sun breaths. So wherever you are on your, whatever seated position you've taken, bring your hands to the heart. Again, drop back into your back body. Take the waist back and the navel back, but still come to the sharp edge of your sits bones and lengthen up through the side body. Open up the armpit chest. And this crown of the head lifting towards the heavens. Elbows are heavy. We'll take a couple of sun breaths. Inhaling the breath, lengthening. Relax the shoulders and relax the hands, extending them to the earth and spreading through the fingers, even the spaces between the fingers. And swoop the arms up over the head. Head back. If that feels comfortable, stretch up even more, but drop the shoulders away from the ears and exhaling the hands back down to the lap. Inhale, exhale, fingers to the earth. Inhale, sweep the arms up over the head. Waist back, navel back. Maybe take another sip of a breath with arms up behind the ears. If possible, they don't need to touch. If they touch in space, that's fine. Lift up again. Open up to the glory all around us. Exhale the hands back down to the heart. Two more times. As you breathe in, lift and lengthen. As you breathe out, honoring the earth. As you breathe in, sweeping around, keep the head facing forward if your neck is sensitive. Otherwise, you can lengthen the back of the head to bring it back. Ooh, exhaling the hands back down to the earth. A nice little ride. One more time. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale. Inhale, sweep. Push the arms a little bit more forward. Feel the muscles of your arms engage. Exhaling, hands back down to the heart. Relax the hands to the lap. Take a few breaths here. Natural breath. Just to make a note of the energy that you've shaken up a little bit just by taking your arms up over the head. Great. And we'll move into my head and neck series, which even if you are a more sort of a more experienced yogi or somebody who's used to going right into, say, sun salutations or strong vinyasa yoga or something like that, take the time to explore these movements. Use them as an opportunity to practice focus and concentration and turning inward and being able to stay with your breath and stay with these movements. So they're kind of slow movements and they are very important to check in with your neck and your shoulders. And the movements will involve dropping the head, lifting it back up, up and down a couple, and then turning it from side to side. And so you can notice whether you have congestion in your neck or whether you have compression and whatnot. You'll be able to notice, hopefully, precisely where those parts are. And we'll give an opportunity to kind of give yourself a little bit of a self-massage. So do the best you can to stick with it. And we'll just begin by relaxing your shoulders, drawing them back, lengthening the front of the body, the clavicle spread, the spine of the shoulder blades spread, and the bottom tips of the shoulder blades move slightly towards each other. And we'll begin just by lengthening the back of the head to draw the chin down towards the chest. Stop when you feel a pull and then back off a little bit. Wherever you feel a pull in the neck and back off. And then inhaling the head up, grounding, supporting your neck with your and head with your shoulders. Waist back, navel back. And then lengthen the head to bring the chin down. Inhaling, bringing the head back, chin up. Maybe going a little further. Head goes into the cradle of the shoulders. Lengthen the head, the back of the head, to bring the chin down. One or two more times. See if you can stay focused in these movements and stay present. That's the journey, that's the work. Stay with sensation. And when your chin next comes down towards the sternum, we'll begin to make little C curls, half circles with the chin. So following the line of your of the clavicle of your shirt, even roll the chin over to either side, and then dropping down. Going over to the other side. If you're going to the right side, lead with your left ear. And if you, when you're going back over to the left side, lead with your right ear. So the whole body is involved, right side and left side. One or two more times. Not too slow and not too fast so that you can really stay present. Notice where you feel clicks and crunches. And we'll meet with our chin over to the right side. And extend out with your right hand. And with the same action as the sun breaths, actively extending through the spaces between the fingers, bring the arm up over the head, elbow up, and the head, the hand, right hand on the right, left ear. Relax your right shoulder and your left shoulder, and resist the head into the hand and the hand into the head a little bit so you can feel the muscles of the left side of the neck engage, and you're stretching out those ropey tight muscles. Roll your right shoulder back, relax your roll both shoulders back actually and down. Resist just enough, head into the hand, hand into the head, and gently, so you're not pushing the head down. And then you can make, crunch, crunch, crunch. You can make little subtle, gentle movements with your head, your hand. There's not an exact position for your hand to be in. Just cradle the back of the head. Very auspicious position. Hand to the back of the head. Drop the gaze, drop your awareness to the back brain. And then you can begin to give yourself a little nice massage on the right side, left side of the neck, up by the insertion of the muscles into the occipital in the back of the head, along the spine, the muscles, the spaces between the spines, pull away from the center of the spine, pushing out and then following along to the shoulder blade and massaging that area. You can take your right hand, left hand, and add to that massage if you like. Stay present. Notice how easy it is to get distracted. But celebrate the knowledge, awareness that you are distracted, and then come back to your fingertips, the muscles, and your breath. Gently turning the head. Good. And then make your way back where your hand is on your head, gently. Bring the head back up to center. Turn the head slightly. So reestablish the center of the crown of the head over the center of the bowl of the pelvis. And then relax your right hand to your lap. Notice the reverberating, resonating energy and the feeling of the muscles from the work, quote unquote, that you've just done. And then go ahead, we'll go to the taking a breath in. Whoo, we'll drop the chin, exhale down, and then take the chin over to the left side. Left side feels very different now. Extend the fingers out long and a nice sun breath up and over your hand to the back of the head. Find a nice position for your hand. And this is a very auspicious position. You see a lot of pictures of reclining yogis and saints with their hand at the back of the head, making that connection. And then gently press the hand into the head, and gently press the head into the hand, making little micro movements, stretching the right side of the neck now. Relax both shoulders away from the ears. Notice, feel your shoulder blades slicing into your back. That's why they're called shoulder blades. And then you can begin to give some self massage. So your right hand can come right up if you like, massaging the ropey muscles of the neck, pulling with your fingertips, pulling the muscles. We try to release the muscles as where they insert into the spine. All the way up, all the way around, up into the insertion of the bone below the ears, squeezing, bringing fresh blood, fresh circulation to these areas, and giving the opportunity to release congestion, release toxins. So with your finger, you can bring it down along the spine and see if you can move your back, your spine, kind of back and forth in a serpentine nature. And maybe you can't even feel the difference between, and if the bones are kind of compressed and congested to each other. And so just note, because that's going to come into play later if we go into movements like the shoulder stand or even when we turn the head. So this is a type of sort of exercises, self-massage that you can do with yourself any time of the day. Preparing to release, guide your hand back to center, and then interlock your fingers behind your head. So interlocking the fingers, every other day, change the interlock, one finger in front, pinky behind. Tomorrow, interlock other forefinger in front, and pinky behind. So take your hand behind your head, maybe even the odd interlock, and then open up the heart, waist back, navel back. So I'm lifting the head and going back, but you don't want to just press into the kidneys and the adrenals. Take those little floating ribs back. Keep the length in your side body, but what lifts is the heart chest. There's you know, there is a little bit of a back bend in the low back, but you want the back bend to come in the space between the shoulder blades. Spread the elbows and bring the elbows towards each other. Spread them out and towards each other and come down. Gently pulling the back of the head and then inhaling. You can take your thumbs right to the base of the skull. Inhale up, spread wide, exhale down. Inhale up, wings spread wide, look up. Exhale down. So it doesn't matter how far you go down. It's however far you want to go. You can come deep or you can just come a little bit. It's up to you. Explore. And then finishing up, coming back up to center, gently lift the head up out of the neck and take the hands up over the head. Still interlocked, elbows slightly towards you, and then turn the palms up, pinky fingers rolling back, thumbs working to touch. Relax the shoulders down away from the ears and then press the hands up. Urdhva Baddha Gulyanasana. Urdhva is upwards, and Baddha Gulyanasana means something about the fingers. That's one of the names of this posture. Press up, but then drop the shoulders down. You don't want to let the shoulders ride up to the ears. Pull them down. Pull the shoulders blades down. Take the waist back and the navel back. Anytime you bring the arms up over the head, you're gonna hyperextend. So you want to adjust waist back, navel back. You can take it a little from side to side. You can take the head in different positions, chin up, chin down. But breathe. Pull the fingers. Try to pull the fingers away from each other. Feel the arms engage. Great. And exhale the hands back down to the lap and just receive. Let the breath come back to normal. See that your feet are still in Tadasana. Seated Tadasana. Your knees are forward. Eye of the knee facing each other. Energetics of the knees is extending from the outer knee into the inner knee, a little bit of a spiral. Feel your arches engage by when you lift your toes. Balance the weight on the four corners of the feet. Lay the toes back down. Forgot to turn off notifications. Breathing. Keep your eyes open, if possible. You want to have a steady gaze, drishti. So your gaze, steady gaze helps you to focus and keep concentration. So when your eyes are wandering over around, then our head, our thoughts tend to wander too. Soft, steady gaze. Relax the shoulders, waist back, navel back. Good. So within that minute or so, hopefully you've been able to kind of turn inward and feel the movement of the energy in the body and the residual effects of the contraction and the extension and the massaging of the shoulders and the neck. And pay attention to those places where you found congestion and tightness and when you feel stuck. And you can always, throughout the day, use your fingers behind your back and your neck, and it's pretty easy to reach to the cervical and down along the back to the thoracic. You may not be able to go all the way down to the mid-thoracic, but usually we can bring our hands back to the neck. And every once in a while, take that time to do that for yourself. Whew. Okay, so let's do some movement now. We worked on the head and the neck and the shoulders, and we'll come to the hips now. So sitting, if you're sitting on the floor, you can still do these movements. You have one leg bent out to the side. Take enough height if you need so that your knee is not higher than your hip. So if you take height with your hips, your knee should drop down. And you may want to support under the knee if the knee is up higher. So take plenty of height, take support, anything that's hanging in air. If you're in the chair, come a little bit to the edge of the chair and then draw your right knee up. So just far enough where about my sits bones are almost to the edge of the chair, but not so I'm going to fall off. There, if you want to, you can even lean back into the chair. So that's yogi's choice. So I'm sitting here, and then when I take my leg from side to side, I can feel my sit bone. And what's moving is the thigh. I'm trying not to move the sit bones or move the hips. My hips are still staying pretty level. And draw the knee up towards the right shoulder, circle the foot. Relax the shoulders, relax the neck, circle in the other direction. It's like Pavana Muktasana, wind relieving pose. Working on, with the right leg, we're working on the ascending colon. And when we take the left leg, we're working on the descending colon. So really nice for intestinal discomfort and for activating our digestive system. Circle, 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 side to side to side, little circles. See if you can isolate the movement into the head of the femur. And then the other direction. Notice where you get stuck. I actually have my finger right down in the crease. This hip is feels a little bit crunchy. So I just got my hand right on the very top of the thigh. I take it out a little bit and back. So, and then draw it back into the chest. Take a breath and take hold of your right foot. Your right foot with your left hand underneath the foot. Hello. And then take the knee, let the knee come out and the foot come towards you. And if you can, sit up tall. Don't round to get here, but lift the foot and bring and drop it back down. So in order to lift the foot, don't round the shoulders. Stay nice and tall. Maybe you can bring the foot all the way up to the insertion of your thigh and your left leg in the half lotus position. You don't want to turn the foot up in this position. So you're on your ankle, and the right side and the left side of the ankle are level. So I'm not collapsing the ankle. If you pull your foot up, you'll notice, so your foot is like in a standing position, in this position. So you can actually draw the foot, the foot comes up a little higher and then turn the foot in, but that's going to change the sensation in your knee. So be very safe with your knee. So in that case, your foot might not even come up here. It might not even go to the knee, so then you just want to keep holding it and sit up tall. It's a great place to be. But if you can take the foot into safely with the knee, take the foot up into the thigh. You don't want to drop the knee, because see how that collapses the ankle. You want to lift the ankle. Have the foot be in like a standing position. And then we're going to take a little twist towards the knee. My right hand comes around. Now I'm actually sort of holding on to my knee because I want that touch sensation to help to tell me if I'm straining my knee. So I'm actually kind of almost massaging my knee a little bit, pushing into the knee, turning. Relax the shoulders. As always, lengthening to as you breathe in. And then the very end of the exhalation, navel draws in and I twist a little deeper. And then I have to drop my shoulders again. Come back to center. Turn away from the leg. My legs are staying where they are, especially my left leg, but I'm turning the trunk and I'm lengthening on the inhalation. The very end of the exhalation, navel draws back, and then I'm twisting a little deeper from there. My left waist is still nice and long, my side body. So not leaning away from the twist, not leaning towards the twist. My ribs on both sides are still level to turn around. The whole body turns. Turn from the right side to the left. And then roll on the exhalation back to center, a little over to the right side. And then you can take a little bit of a forward extension. But not if you strain the knee, just letting yourself come forward just enough, and you can hug that knee. And this is, again, really nice for all of your digestive organs, not to mention helpful for the movement of your knee and your hips. And to release the back, it's nice to release the legs. Okay, sitting up tall, love that knee. Sit up tall, be on the center, sharp edge of your sits bones if possible. So certainly you can do these movements, leaning back into the chair and, you know, moving the leg around, and that's perfectly fine. But if you can sit up straight, it's even better. You can take a breath in, breathe in, shoulders back. Levelize everything again, and then take hold of the knee and the foot, right knee, and then take it back to center, and then guide it back to center. Hold on to the back of the thigh and extend the leg. And you can circle the foot again. Notice how when you circle the foot, it's connected all the way up to the knee. Circle in the other direction. Take the foot all the way behind the ear. Just kidding. Not me in any lifetime. But if you can take the yogi toe hold, two fingers to the toe, and still keep the sits bones even, go ahead and do that. Otherwise, hold the back of the leg. Lean back into like a half of a boat position. Good. And then guide the leg back, bend the knee, and place your foot back down onto the earth. Adjust your sits bones. Take a breath and breathe here, back in Tadasana, seated Tadasana. Knees facing my toes. Balance evenly on the inside and the outside of the foot. Waist back, navel back. Knees internally rotating, but still space between your knees. Good. Noticing the difference between the right leg and the left leg now. What sensations have you shaken up? I don't know how to say it. How does it feel? Right leg, left leg. And now we'll do the left side. So let go of the right side. Work that you did on the right side. But tell your right leg to stay where it is. If you're seated on the floor again, your right leg crossed, place something underneath your right leg. But if you're seated at the edge of the chair, Tell your right leg to stay where it is. Hello, don't move. And then pick up your left leg. And then we'll start here. Same movements on the other side. So let go of side one. Be here now. A little cradling. Oh, let's see. How do we do this? Oh, so first holding on to the back of the knee, or the front of the knee, actually, and do little circles. And then circle in other direction. As best you can, your right leg is staying put. Other direction, maybe out to the side a little. Completely different than the right leg. Feel your sit bone on the chair. You're going to kind of be rolling back and forth over your sit bone, but have the movement be in the head of the femur. So this leg is much freer than this leg for me. Drawing it up, drawing it around. I don't feel any kind of stickiness or stuckedness here. Draw the knee up to the chest. Pavana Muktasana. Circle the foot. Sit up tall. Shoulders back. Equal weight on both sit bones. And then taking hold of the foot with your right hand, another auspicious connection, hand and the bottom of the foot, which is usually on the Mother Earth. Say thank you to your legs for taking you on this journey, and then we'll pull the foot up, and then take your left leg, left hand underneath your shin. And here again, little side-to-side actions. Your right leg might move out a little bit, but do the best you can to keep the weight evenly on the sit bone on your right side. And then as you take the leg out and take it in, take it out and take it in, see if you can possibly bring your foot all the way up to the insertion. Otherwise, keep holding onto the foot, or you can place it on the right foot on the right knee. But most importantly, be very safe with your left knee in this movement here. So no strain. If you can take the foot up, great. So if you're just holding on the foot and we're doing the little twist, you want to just do really, really just baby twists. Pay attention to your knee. What's twisting is the trunk of the body. Don't twist the knee. So I can take my foot all the way up to the top. Be like your foot is still on a standing way. Don't pull the foot under. And then twist away from the leg, towards the leg. When I twist to the left, I'm pulling my knee in towards me. Check your shoulders. Have they risen up to the ears? And drop them back down, shoulder blades into the back. One or two more breaths. Lengthen as you inhale, and then at the very end of the exhalation, the navel moves in. Twist from there. Nice massage to your abdominal organs. Inhale, lengthen. Whoo, exhale, come back to center, and we're going to turn to the other side. Right hand comes to the back of the chair. Left hand on my knee. So now my left hand is on my right knee, and I'm resist my knee into my leg and my leg into my knee. So feel the shape. Feel what shape that you've taken in space. Feel, notice the center of the brain, you right back over the center of the bowl of the pelvis. Even though we're going to the right, be aware of your left side. Very end of the exhalation, belly draws in, twist a little deeper. My right foot is relatively active. Good. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, we turn, untwist. Spring back to center. Over, pass, a little pass, and then back to center. Take hold of your left leg and then draw it back. Foot toward, foot still lifted, but knee forward again, and then extend that leg. If you can take the yogi toe hold, great. Sit up tall. Any amount of rounding, you want to take the knee away from you. So the more you round, you're going to be closing up everything. So you want to keep that nice and open. Circle the foot. What's your right leg doing? Is it staying in place? Ask it to. And then a little bit of a boat pose with one leg, one-legged boat. Notice how my spine is still nice and long. I'm not rounding my back at all. A little bit of a back bend in the shoulder blades. And then taking the foot and placing it back onto the earth. Come back to Tadasana and breathe. Your base again, set it up. Know that your feet are active enough to lift the arches, weight evenly distributed on the inside of the outside of the foot. Check to see that your knees are in line with your toes. Waist back, navel back, all of that. Same, not even different. And breathe, receive. Feel. Circulation, whatever you feel, maybe a little shakiness, perhaps a little bit lighter, less dense, less heavy. There's no right or wrong. Great. So we'll just see. Just breathe for a second. Okay, so let's come down onto the floor. Here, you want to take some height. Probably, unless your hamstrings are really nice and long, because it's what prevents you from going forward in your forward extensions is your hamstrings. So if your hamstrings are tight, then and you have a difficult time nutating or lifting up out of your hips and extending forward, then you want to take a little bit of height to get that to free you up a little bit. And again, that's what we want to be doing here. We want to be free. So let's take Janu Sirsasana. We'll be doing our closing poses now, calming. Pull the flesh away from your sits bones. So lean to the left. My left leg, draw the leg up into bent leg position, and then lay that leg down and pull the heel in. Turn back to center. Pull the flesh away from the sits bones. Pull, broaden, pull that thigh muscles from underneath you. Draw the toes towards you even as you're pressing out through the heel and just turn towards the leg. So even here it's a little bit of a twist. If you have your chair in front of you, you can use your chair and come out over the chair. Bring the earth up to you. Otherwise, lead with the heart and come forward any amount until your shoulders start to round and lift back up again and breathe and extend forward. I'm leading with my heart, not my head. So forehead lengthening. Take your right hand as a kickstand and lift up both sides of the trunk to extend so you're not sinking. If you can let go without collapsing, you can bring your right hand to your right leg. Quadriceps active. So when you pull your toe towards you, you want to feel your quadriceps engage. And when you press your heel away from you, you feel your hamstrings engage. Both are engaged. So my knee, my leg is straight, but I'm not just pressing my knee down. Where are the shoulders? Away from the ears. Shoulder blades moving down the back. Lengthen the side body so the spine can flow freely and effortlessly. Inhale, walk yourself back up to center. And then turn towards that bent leg and extend out over with the right side. Any amount. So your hand is on the inside, right hand on the inside of my knee, twist. My foot is pressing onto the inside of my right thigh. Excellent for your immune system. Head back. And then lengthen again. Turn all the way over to that leg and extend perhaps a little bit more to the center. And then inhale the breath. Come back up. Take your left hand, lift up that left leg, extend it out so your both legs are extended. And then from underneath your right leg, lift up your knee, draw the knee towards you, and then lay the leg down onto the earth. So if your knee is up really high, that's when you want to take more support, a couple more blankets. Or a firm cushion or bolster if you have a yoga bolster. I wish I had a yoga bolster still. That's what I'm going to buy with my stimulus package money. I'm going to buy a bolster. So sit bones, even as always. Same, even though my right leg is out to the side, I'm still sitting on both sit bones. So a little bit more weight has to come over to the right left leg. But extend out through my right knee and then lift up. Lift out of your hips and extend forward. So same with on this side. It's completely different than my other side. If you have a chair here, just come to the chair and breathe. If you can keep extending down, every time you go down, lift up the heart and then lengthen even more. Lift up, lengthen, lift up, lengthen. My leg is active, quadriceps pulling up. Hamstrings engaged. Pull the flesh away from the sit bones on the left side. So reach underneath and pull the flesh away. Again, if you're on the chair, you're just up here. Same sensation. So I can get down to the floor, but what's down on the floor? Just my rug, a little bit of dust, maybe some pumpkin seeds or raisins from my antioxidant mix. Left hand, kickstand. Breathe in to lengthen yourself back up with your kickstand. Turn away from the left leg. Left hand to the inside of the leg. Twist. My trunk, still in Tadasana. You know what that means. And then extend out over that leg, any amount. If you have the freedom, so it's a twist, you're turning the left side to the right, extending the left trunk over that leg. If you have the ability, your right hand might come all the way over to your foot and then roll open like you're going to fall over. Otherwise, wherever you are, keep the shoulders back, as always. Janushirasana, Parvritta. And then lengthen, lift both sides of the body and turn the right trunk around and extend out over the leg one more time. Janushirasana. Or just to the chair, or just sitting up straight. Some people's forward extensions are sitting up straight. Good, so walk yourself back up to center and breathe. Notice the energy in the body. Notice the breath. And then take your right leg back up. Extend it out. Take a little bit of a forward extension here. Intense stretch of the west side of the body. And the west side of the body is the back body. And every time we can open up our back body, we're increasing awareness in our back body, and we can be more aware in the world. And if we're more aware and conscious, the more cells we have in our body, the more we can be compassionate. So your forward extension, active legs, you may only be able to come this far with your hand to the arms on the chair, sitting up straight, perfectly fine. If you have the length in the hamstrings and the freedom of your sacrum in your back, you can extend out. Both sides of my trunk are nice and long. They're a long line. They're not a curved mount, circle. Every time I go down, I'm going to lift the heart. My legs are straight. This tradition, in this time right now anyway, straight legs. And then breathing, lengthen, inhale, walk yourself back up to center. Take your feet together, knees out to the side for a brief Baddha Konasana. Draw up on that second layer of the pelvis, like a little bit of a Kegel. So you're on your sits bones, but draw up muscularly, and then it's just an energetic move. So a little bit of a Kegel, my lady friends, but it's the second layer of muscle lifting up. If your knees are really high, you want to take more height, or just be here now. You don't have to go finding anything. Ultimately, it's nice to have your knees as the same height as your hips, because it's harder to sit up. Find a way to sit up. If you have to support your knees, great. But lift up the bottom layer of muscles in the pelvic floor, and then breathe from the earth all the way up to the crown of the head. Like a straw. Down into the earth and up to the heavens. Take a few breaths here. Shoulders relaxed. Sip the energy from the earth up through the heavens, into the heavens, and from the heavens down back into the earth. A couple of breaths. And then you can even just let that go, but try to keep the Kegel. This position is actually one of the first drawings of, it's actually like a rock drawing of a yoga position that's probably 6,000 years old. We don't even know. I think the being has little horns coming out of his head. (Clears throat) Your legs aren't pressing down to the side, down, they're pressing up, they're lengthening out to the side. And drawing back into the groins. From your sacrum, extend out to the knees and draw back into the groins. Kegel. Center the spine, still over the bowl of the pelvis, even if my knees are up high. And then bring the knees together. And we'll take Shavasana. Relaxation. The most, perhaps, the most important pose that you can take. 5 minutes of not moving. Open awareness. Relaxation. Allow the effects of the and of the movements to settle. So that, please take this time for yourself. Best thing to do then is going bounding back out into the world. So you can take your chair and lie back with your feet on the chair and your back on the floor. That's a nice way, especially if you have low back stuff. Or you can just lie back on the earth. And you can use a blanket underneath your head. Just your head. And then roll the blanket up. One roll. So from behind, see if I can show. Or not. You don't have to have a blanket. And also, if you're lying on the floor, you can lie with your knees together and your feet apart. So, yogi's choice. Lying back with my feet together and my knees apart. Taking my blanket, curling the blanket slightly, bringing it up to my shoulders. Roll the arms from the inside out so you can come onto the full triangle of the shoulder blade. Scoot your hips a little so you come on the full triangle of the sacrum. Ground the heels. Close your eyes and come home to your breath. I'll ring the bell. When it's time to come out of Shavasana. Ideally, for an hour-long practice, it's ideally to take 10 minutes for relaxation. Because it takes a few minutes for your body just to calm down, and your mind to calm down, to come to more of a sense of stillness. So, let the breath flow freely and effortlessly through your body. Exhale out any excess energy. Blowing it out through your mouth. And then see if you can come to a regular breathing pattern where your inhalations match the exhalations and you're breathing in and out through your nose. Relax the palms of your hand, the palms, your fingers very lightly curled. Relax the lips. If the lips part, that's fine. Relax the jaw, the cheeks. Notice any furrows or lines in the brow and smooth them out with your awareness. Right. Relaxing the eyes. Outer eyes release towards the temples. Inner eyes release towards the bridge of the nose. outer eyes, relax, release towards the temples. Inner eyes, release towards the bridge of the nose. Drop the inner gaze to the back of the brain, the base of the skull. Tip of the tongue barely touching the back of the teeth. And release, relax the tongue from the tip of the tongue all the way back to the root of the tongue. Space between the ears, the blue sky of the mind. It's vast, it's boundaryless, luminous. There's no right side, no left side, no inside, no outside, just the blue sky of the mind. Your thoughts are like birds fly across that blue sky, and they're here and they're gone without leaving a trace. Breath freely, effortlessly moving through the body. The blue sky of the mind. There's no top, there's no bottom. There's no inside or outside, right side or left side, just a vast, luminous blue sky of the mind. The thoughts are like birds that fly across the sky. They're here and they're gone. And if you're aware of the thought, mental formations rising, back to the breath. Back to the spaces between the breaths. It's easy to fall in a hall of mirrors. Mistake the moon on the water for the moon itself. It's easy to get stuck in the minus rag banks of the muddy mind and stay there forever, afraid of having to fly. It's easy to loot the heart for its last honest beat, but the toes know the difference an inch of solid ground can make. The arms know that the wavering heart opens to the endless marsh, and the fingers know to spread their tips into wings when the cage door opens and the bottom fails. The bottom falls out. arms know that the wavering heart opens to an endless marsh, and the fingers know to spread their tips into wings when the cage door opens and the bottom falls out. Gradually making your way back to normal waking consciousness, keeping your eyes softly closed. Invite your inhalations to be a little bit deeper and your exhalations a little bit longer. And just trace your breath. Trace your awareness as it percolates out once again towards your fingers and your toes. With each deeper exhalation, and when you feel ready, making little micro movements with your fingers, wiggling your toes. These micro movements moving towards more macro movements. When you feel ready, bending your knees. Roll to the side. Use your bottom arm as a pillow. Take a few breaths there before making your way back up to a comfortable seated position. So, thank your body, thank your mind, your spirit, your breath, for all joining in together in this practice of mindful movement. Take these movements out into your life. Don't have to wait to grab a chair or roll out a yoga mat, to roll the shoulders or gently press the head or take the arms over the head or do a little twist, right? Throughout the day, know that it's a great way to shift your energy and to change it up a little bit. And mindfulness in everything that you do, be aware as much as you can. Be in the present moment where all things are possible. There's a time to make plans and, you know, make lists and figure out something about the past or make a plan for the future. But know that ruminating over the past or fantasizing over the future is what causes suffering, literally. Regrets, attachments, wanting things to be different, that's where we suffer. Do what you need to do. Do it the best you can. Start to trust that your life will divinely unfold. And you'll start to see the things you may have wanted actually show up in your life. You might not have even known what the details were. So have high aspirations, but let go of expectations. You don't know what exactly what the details are going to be. So thank you again for joining me. Hey, Scott, Will, Jab, Robert, Don, John, hey, Margie, Al, Elizabeth, wonderful, Kathleen, Jocelyn, my sister Christine, Jim, Randy, Janelle, hey, Mitch, and Henry, and Tom, and Henry, and Terry. So those are the names that people have chimed in and said, hello, and maybe there's more out there. And there's billions of other people in this world who want the same thing. We all want happiness. So let go of expectations. Let go of judgment. Let go of wanting things to be different. Do what you need to do in the here and now. And I'll see you back tomorrow at 3:30 perhaps, or tonight at 8 o'clock for our evening satsang meditation. You can pull these up anytime on my Facebook page. And I will end, as always, with my prayer of the heart, which is saying that everything is perfect. Even in imperfection, there's perfection. And even in perfection, there's imperfection. So we are all perfect, aren't we? Om Pranamada, Pranamadam, Pranat Pranamadachite, Pranasya, Pranamadaya, Pranamadevavashite, Om Shanti, 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 Hari Om, Shri Guru Vyon Namaha, Hari Om. I, and you can as well, dedicate the merit and the virtue gained through this practice to the lasting happiness and well-being of all beings, so all beings may be free from suffering and the causes and conditions of suffering. Namaste. Peace be with you. Aloha.